Please.
Shalom, my name is Isser Schneider. I want to talk about Orthodox Judaism today. There may be 57 varieties. And we have to have respect for each other. Halavai, halavai. It should not be sinas chenam. And each one has to go the way that he has been taught by his parents, or the way that he has chosen for himself. If he's a Baal Tshuva, or if he's left the way of his forefathers and chosen a new way. A kol tov, as long as it's in, within the miskeret, Shlomei Emuni Yisrael, within the magic circle. Now, there are those who have actually amissed that they're not satisfied with the ways that we have, be it the Briske Derech, the Derech of the Chazanish, the Derech of the Ben Ish Chai, but looking for something more Mikori. Like, we know this is the Derech of the Ben Magon. You want to go back to the Hasidi Ashkenaz, which, by the way, the Nusach Ashkenaz is... I don't know if you're allowed to say this, it's Malachoti. If you look at the Nusach of, in the Mahzavitri, the Nusach of Rashi, he put out recently a very beautiful version of the Mahzavitri, and you have the two different Nuschot that in those days, it was before printing, there was only a Ketav Yad of the Siddur in front of the Chazan, and the people would say after him, and it's left over, Ketav Yad from the different shuls that were in France, and there were two different nuschayas, but both of them are very close to the nusach of Edot Mizrach. The nusach Ashkenaz was something was invented by the Hasidi Ashkenaz. They took out words because whatever, Ruach HaKodesh, whatever you want to say. So when you daven nusach Ashkenaz, you're not davening Rashi's nusach or Ben Atam's nusach, you're davening the nusach of the Rokeach, or close to it. The Ben Gurion took out certain things that were in the Nusach Ashkenaz in his time that like crept in, like the Bismashiach and the Kasabayas of David from the Arizal, other things from the Arizal. Okay, so that has to be realized, that you're just going back to the 1300s, you're not going back to Ravashi.
Rabbi Schneider.
Yes, sir.
If you mention Mizmor Shir Lachan of the Sabayas, I'll tell you what I heard from Rav Benzion Metzafi Shlita, that he mentions, you know, he gives a nusach, somebody who has no time and has to skip like crazy, what the must things he has to say. And he must say Aromimcha in Mizmor Shir.
Must say Aromimcha? Okay.
Aromimcha ad your day vor. That's the minimum a person must say, according to the Arizal, of course.
I don't know, this is news to me. I mean, it says in the Shulchan Aruch what you're supposed to say.
Good. We said now, Rabbi Schneider, we're saying the absolute minimum. Rabbi Metzafi gave us absolute minimum.
Okay.
What you must daven in Pesukei Dezimra, that you cannot skip a Beshuva.
From Aromimcha to, I didn't understand, to what?
Aromimcha, from Aromimcha, ad maybe three Pesukim, ad Yordei Bor.
Okay. But to know, in any case, the Ben Gurion says, don't say it. Okay. Each one according to his minute. The thing is that, okay, so we're saying that the Ben Gurion is like Yehudi, right? He's like very original, that he was willing to cut away. He was in the 1700s, and he wants to go back to the 1200s. He wants to go back 500 years. And most of the G'dayim do a more, let's say, Shlomo Kluger, they're very conservative. He went with, you know, as they were. Okay, nechon, Rashi daven what he daven, and the Rekeach daven what he daven. But now each generation is involved, right? You have the theory of evolution, right? He's in little vowels, and each generation, according to the neshamas could calm down. They have to stick with, you know, what they have. But the Ben Gurion says no, and the Ben Gurion is the potech petach for the Radvina with the Tchailis, for instance, without the Magoin, I don't know if it could be a Radvina. The Magoin says, we'll go back to the Lukeach. The Radvina says, okay, we'll go back all the way back to the time of the Amoraim. In the time of the Amoraim, there was Tchailis. Okay, so we have the Zuberman people who are going back, who want to reconstitute the way of the Vimagoin. Fine and dandy. And we have the Rabbi Chaim who wants to go more with the Rambam missed him. And we have the Migdash people. I was with Rabbi Chaim for a number of years, and together we worked with the Migdash and other Inyonim. And here, the union of what Chazal say, Shelo Nagu covered Zeh B'Zeh, in other words, if you're in the same, like, a brisker can have more, it's easier for him to have covered for a Chaznish person, because they're both going the old way, right? They're both going, they're not trying to be Ibir Chachomim, to say, well, you know, we'll go back to Ravashi. So, but it's hard for them, it's hard for the conservative people to have respect for somebody who says, you know, they want to go back to Chaylis and all that. You think, who do you think you are? And on the other hand, the New Age people, if you can call them that, so you have to have respect for people. So you're not willing to budge an inch. You have to stick exactly to what your great grandfather did. It's very difficult. It's a big nisoyin, this thing of having kavod. And there's another inyan that many times people are stuck in something that's really not good for them, because like the derech of the chaznish is very, very dry. And like the Rav Sosanti, we went for a while with the way of the Magoin, of, you know, being Mevar called Dovel Asukei Shmaitali V'Hilch. And he said, no, it's too dry. It cuts down the person's inventiveness. And he went back to the old way. Rav Sosanti went back to the old way of tremendous pulling. And we have like a Boch Berlevich, who was a tremendous Ilui, and Rav Chaim was matan to him and says, no, we can't make new ideas, we just can understand the Rishonim. In any case, you have Bisk, which is very, very cold analysis, and you have the Chaznitz, which is very dry, and it could be, it kills people. Some people, they're stuck in it, they're born into it, or they, by the tshuva, they go into it, it's not good for them, it's not good for the neshamas. There's nobody there to pull them out, and they die from it. This is also called, it has to be, you know, it's part of the story, that once you have a derech and people get into it, for some people it's not good, and they don't have enough sechel to realize that it's not good for them, and it kills them. Okay? So it's a, this is part of the story. In any case, I want to talk about the Baal Shem Tov, that, on the one hand, the Baal Shem Tov is very conservative, although he says not to learn the Mefarshim of the Shulchan Aruch. He says, just learn the Shulchan Aruch, like the Beis Yosef wanted. He should finish the Shulchan Aruch in a month. I don't know if the Baal Shem Tov said that to the Kach, but he said, you shouldn't look in the Mefarshim, only if it's Nagei Adamaisa. You shouldn't get, you know, involved. I mean, people don't do that. I mean, Sakman, they all, you know, they're learning the, you know, the Paschim is all the Mefarshim. But according to Baal Shem Tov, it is not the right way. It's supposed to, you're supposed to, you know, learn the Shulchan Aruch quickly. And, well, I think one of the most important teachings about Shem Tov is that he says, Torah Hashem Tamima. It hasn't been touched. You know, even if you don't understand, don't think you understand. I was talking to somebody last night, he said, well, yeah, I'm Shema Tishma. It's only Shema Tishma, then you get the bracha. I don't know, that's what it seems to me, but who says we understand it? Very hard for me to think that we understand things. The Baal Shem Tov says, no, Torah Hashem Tamima, Mishiris Nefesh, Mishiris Nefesh is, that we know that we don't understand it. It's Tamima, we haven't touched it. So what we need is a lot of Yirat Kavod, and not that we don't know anything what we're doing, but we have to do it. We have to learn Torah. This is what gives us Oilem HaBoah and Oilem HaZeh, but the Maisa, we really don't understand anything. I mean, that's the Bechel of Hashem Tov. I mean, it's not exactly the Bechel of Rambam, by far not. But this is what the Hashem Tov teaches us, that we should know that we don't understand, and that we, so that gives a tremendous, yes, a cover that, you know, like, by the Martin Torah that they went back. They retreated because they realized it was like too much for them. That's the way we have to live, according to the Bar Center, constantly. To know that we don't understand anything, and it's really, it's like way, way above us. But we have to have my Shabbat to give it over to us, the tzaddik. That's why you have to go to a tzaddik. Because only the tzaddik can translate it for you. And in each generation, there's the neshama of my Shabbat, we believe, is the parts of the Kiyamis. You have to be connected to all the parts of the Kiyamis, because they're translating it for us in such a way that we can accept it, even though we don't understand anything at all. But it's through their tinor that we make the Torah, with Naima, Amen.
Amen, amen. Rabbi Schneider, perhaps you want to say a few more words about Rav Yitzhak Shlomo Zilberman. You mentioned him a little bit.
I don't really know much about him. I respect him fully. I think it's a very good thing. But unfortunately, they attack other people. They attack Hasidim. This is very bad. It's, you know, and each shita has, it's very hard to have a shita that's completely MS, that's completely Rachmanos. I think Breslev is that. I believe Breslev is MS and Rachmanos. It goes together, right? Shri Sati Ferris.
Again, please? What? Again? What? What is interference?
I'm saying that I'm a Breslover because I believe Breslover is the best shita because it has the MS and it has Rachmanis. It's not attacking other people. The Rebbe attacks somebody. Okay, the Rebbe says the Rambam is wrong. The Rambam is wrong because the Rebbe is very against, like we're just speaking, very against this type of, you know, thinking that you understand, you know, and telling what the Talmi HaMitzvahs are according to your understanding. That's very bad according to the Rebbe. Not to read it. I mean, he doesn't attack the Rebbe. Don't read that. Don't get involved in that. But the Zilberman people, from what I hear, they're very against Hasidus, which is not good. But you don't want it to say that. Nobody's forcing you. Nobody's force-feeding you. You don't have to have the... Nobody's... You know, if the best of us come and put this for me in the Beis Medrash, okay, so take them out. I don't know. Put them in the Gliese. Put them in another Beis Medrash. Nobody's forcing you, but this antagonism is very bad. Okay, we have to do tshuva. We have to... It's a guy with a person think he knows the truth. We don't know the truth. It's just, who are we Mekusha to? Besides, the Zuman people want to be Mekusha to the Zuman going. It's very, very good. Be Mekusha to the Zuman going. What are you attacking Hasidus? Shiyah Shalom, B'nai Amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Rabbi Schneider.